Hey guys, this is Chandi.
And this is Milk.
And we're bringing you episode 1, BC.
In the dungeon floor.
Yes. A series where we go through and two-man every 5-man in the game.
Why, you ask? Because we can.
I'm Chandi, I'm the warrior tank, I'm on the bottom left.
And I'm the druid in the top right.
So why don't you tell the people why you picked a druid?
Well, all of my healers have always been priests. Except for one of my shamans, but shamans don't count. And I really didn't like the renew spell, and I didn't like the idea of healing over time. So I picked what I didn't like the most, and
it's kind of an awkward approach. I picked a warrior because I like the playstyle. Okay.
Yeah, we did a lot of thinking. We figured that a Pally-Priest combo would be like the most overpowered. But we decided to gimp ourselves and just have more fun with it by choosing, you know, different things.
Yeah, we also decided to gimp ourselves by kind of going lax on the gear.
One thing, we don't like bind on account gear.
Oh,
it's just hugely overpowered.
Yeah, that stuff is like epic. It's like epics on all levels. Epics that stay updated at that.
Yeah, and we're also not using like overpowered enchants. Another thing about the gear is that we're not necessarily like updating it all the time.
No. Not at all.
We're just getting whatever we get out of the dungeons.
We're just kind of running with it.
If you're dungeon running, you're probably getting better gear than us, because we're just... we'll be getting so much more experience. You will have better gear than us.
Yeah.
We're also not using, like, Mongoose or Crusaders, because...
Yeah, we're not using a whole lot of enchants.
Just overpowered. Yeah. We'll have, like, maybe a little bit of Stam, a little bit of Int.
I think Milk uses a few, like, healing-related enchants, like Intellect mainly. But, I only use a shield. I don't even have any enchants. I just use a shield spike just because it makes it run faster.
Yeah, I mean, speaking of fast, like, as you've seen, we like doing, like, large pulls because...
That's how we do.
I mean, because we can. We might as well. Like, I can heal through that, like,
because
nonchalant.
Because we can. That's all the reason you ever need. Because we can.
Because we can. So, we get to the first boss.
I call him Badass because I cannot pronounce his name.
He's easy, spankin' tank, he's dumb. We clear a lot more trash, we get to Sneed's room.
Oh, Sneed's room.
The Shredder. He's fun.
So what are your thoughts on the room itself?
The room itself is kind of like awkward because there are so many goblins in there, but if you just like take it just a little bit slower, it's just easy. I can be ADD if I want.
Yeah.
Climb on some logs. I really enjoy those logs, alright? They're sweet.
That's what she said. I really enjoyed those logs. You do realize a lot of people are going to hear this, right?
That's okay.
Okay. Alright.
And, see, you had no idea what I was doing, but I...
Yeah, I was kind of angered, you know, going back and watching this, because... Turns out he actually didn't have me quite under such a watchful eye as I thought, but...
Yeah.
So I killed the boss by myself, and then the goblin jumps out of a shredder, and as a tank, you gotta make sure that you can do some snap aggro and get the goblin on you. Could you? Yeah, snap aggro, like that. I can't snap, so I have to, like, give him the signal. Yeah, like that. And snap aggro, get him on you, make sure it doesn't hit anybody.
Like, the first target he's going to attack is the tank. Or no, not the tank, the healer. And if the healer's not ready for it, he'll freak out, and it could wipe the group.
Yeah, you just got to be alert. You got to be on your toes.
Yeah. Just being alert is a very important thing.
Very important.
Up here in the foundry, after we clear a bunch of adds, we got the engineers who like to summon extra people.
Very bad things
they,
happen.
Like, I'm telling you right now, they will wipe your group if you're not alert for them. They will summon and summon and summon as many as they can. Kill the engineers quick.
Yeah, they summon them periodically, and they don't really have, like, a limit to how many they can summon. The thing is that we don't have any DPSers, so we didn't bring down the engineers fast.
And they kind of overpowered us a bit.
Yeah, his mana just, like, dwindled, and then we just wiped.
To be fair, though, this was, like, a four-minute fight that had gone on, so I was hurting for mana.
Yeah, you know, you'd used all of the things at your power, you know, maximum mana efficiency, 5SR, all of that.
Yeah, so we walk back, we kill a patrol, have some fun chasing rats, and then we clear the rest of the room.
You and those damn rats. So we clear the foundry, kill the boss in the foundry.
He was easy. I mean, ironically...
Honestly, the bosses are the easiest parts of the dungeon.
I mean, because it's just one person at a time, or, like, they'll have a couple adds.
Yeah.
Easy.
Looking at my recount charts, like, I can honestly see that the bosses sometimes do less damage than the mobs before them.
Yeah.
It doesn't make any sense to me, but...
We clear some adds, blow up a door, kill some pirates. We get to a Mr. Smite, the first mate.
Yes, Mr. Smite.
You just need to be a little careful of him. He does 3 stuns throughout his lifespan.
And when you pull him, he starts off with two adds with him. So there's the 2 adds and the stun. What you want to do is you want to pull him some ways back on the bridge and then kill the 2 adds and then kill him.
Because otherwise, it's like being stunlocked in PvP. You're just toast.
Yeah, you just get the beat down without being able to do anything. So you do all of that. You kill him. Keep going.
We manage everything. It's kind of easy up until a point.
Yeah, kind of wish it wasn't that easy, because you kind of started to drift away a little bit.
Yeah, I started dancing. In retrospect, I need to find, like, a way to keep myself more aware. But I mean, like, it was okay, because right there we have that wheel of inaccessibility.
That wheel is actually really nice. I mean. What can you do with it?
I mean, if you're in a tight spot and you're a healer or you have a res spell, you can jump on that wheel. Nothing in the entire instance can touch you.
They
will deag when everyone else dies, and you can just res everybody.
You're really going to want to keep that wheel in mind when you start getting close to the ramp and you start getting near the captain.
Yeah, because if you ag the captain while you're on the ramp, he will run all the way around, grab 8 or so mobs with you, and your group is gone.
Yeah, he actually has a pretty massive aggro radius, so basically if you're anywhere near the ramp when he's going by, chances are he'll notice you. So what you want to do is you want to pull the mobs and not tank them near the ramp. You want to tank them away from the ramp.
All right.
And you want to make sure that he's not standing at the top of the ramp whenever you walk by.
Yeah, so we avoid the ramp. We kill the captain. He's also, like, fluff like all the rest of the bosses have been until now. Then we run into a slight problem at VC.
Yeah. Yeah, you started having some kind of creative lag.
Yeah, I lag often, and in this fight it was no different. I just had a bit of lag, but I learned a couple of things. If I send out a heal, it will get all the way through.
Yeah.
I just gotta, you know...
Upload and download.
Yeah, like, I can upload, like, stuff, but it's normally the downloading that I have problems with.
So, to you, on your screen, it doesn't look like your heals are going off, but... All they have to do is tell you what my health is, and you can push the button that corresponds to the heals.
Which is what we did.
Yep.
So how does the rest of the fight go?
Well, he basically, Van Cleef, when you pull him, he starts off with 2 adds, and as his health goes down, he summons 2 more. So there's 4 altogether. What you want to do is you want to start off and kill the 2 at the start, and then kill him. As you're killing him, he'll summon 2 more, and you want to, as a tank, you want to just make sure you got that snap aggro again. Yeah, like that. Snap aggro. I wish I could do that. That'd be so cool. I tried since I was very young, and this is all I get. You probably can't even hear it, but...
So we kill VC, like a snap.
Yep.
And the instance is over, but not yet.
It's not actually over.
There's one more boss. I kid you not, with a 5-man group, it'll take you 30 seconds. You just jump off the side, and you kill Cookie. He's got an okay mace and a really good wand.
Oh, yes.
Like, this wand is the best in I don't know how many levels.
At least, like, 5. At least 5. But, so, yeah. We We jump down, kill him, and that is the end of the run.
If you notice, we didn't get the achievement yet. We had level locked because there's so many dungeons at this level, and we ran this one once to check to see how it was, but after here, you're going to be getting our first runs, be it for better or worse. Alright, so this has been Milk.
This has been Trondy.
And the Dungeon Floor. Have yourself a merry little Christmas.
Peace out, Girl Scout.
Hey, I'm also out of mana.
It's okay. You lasted just long enough. That is.
Sounded so wrong.
And we got a pet, so I'm gonna shadow meld.
Shrink. They're gonna walk right into you.
We'll see about that. Oh, fine.